The desire to make images move, the need to capture movement. I think this is a mystical urge. It's an attempt to capture the mystery of who and what we are and then contemplate that mystery. I remember when I was about 5 or 6, somehow I was able to see someone project a 16-millimeter cartoon. And I was allowed to look inside the projector, and I saw these little still images passing mechanically through the gate at a very, very steady rate of speed. And in the gate, they were upside down. And on the screen, they came out right side up, moving. Something clicked then. And I became involved with the cause of preservation in the early 80s when I really understood just how fragile film was. It wasn't so long ago that nitrate films were melted down just to get the silver content back. In the 70s and 80s, prints of films were recycled to make guitar picks and plastic heels for shoes. We have to really take good care of what's left. Everything from the acknowledged masterworks of cinema to industrial films, home movies, anthropological films, anything that could tell us who we are, ultimately. You're like an angel, too good to be true. The common image or idea of who we are and who we've been and who we're becoming. And the miracle of cinema is that it gives us that common image, that common idea, in time and motion, shot by shot. And since the early 90s, around the time we formed the Film Foundation, I think there actually has been a shift in consciousness and much more awareness of the need for preservation, which is ongoing, by the way, because it isn't something that you do once. You have to keep going back, constantly moving the films from one format to another to make sure they survive. We can't afford to let ourselves be guided by cultural standards, particularly now. I mean, there was a time when the average person wasn't even aware of box office grosses. Since the 80s, it's become kind of a sport and really a form of judgment. It culturally trivializes film. We need to remember that there are other values beyond the financial. Why preserve? Well, because we can't know where we're going unless we kind of know where we've been. We can't understand the future of the present until we have some sort of grappling with the past. And we need to say to ourselves that the moment has come when we have to treat every last moving image as reverently and respectfully as the oldest book in the Library of Congress.
He's in the desk.
Holy heck.
For the love of...
Stop it!
Give me that. What a break!